Random inspiration struck again. I had just a very brief, very small, very incomplete little vision that just randomly came to my mind of basically this little section right here, just the 2x2 or 2x3 kind of size of shape. It wasn't absolutely completely fleshed out. I didn't know exactly what pieces would be used in terms of which wedge plates needed to be employed to create the shape, but I had just that came to mind as a shape to try for a bit of the front end of kind of a near future concept version of a cabover semi-rig to build. And so I built that front section, basically this two-stud tall section here on the front going all the way across, and then built the rest of the cab from there. And obviously the trailer that's connected right now, just for the sake of example, is not my own design. That's just a barely modified version of a official Lego one, but I wanted to show something in context because this does need to actually work in my city, and that does put some additional limitations on it that would not be there if I was not getting this to work with that standardized system. The same system for hitching also works with the intermodal trailers, which I've got the heavily modified design that's based off the basic concept of the Maersk ones that Lego did for the Maersk train set. But unlike these, which have the floating axles in the back so that no matter what height you're at, you're still gonna have all four tires in contact with the ground, this one actually does not have the floating system. So this needs to be at the correct angle in order to have all four tires on the ground at any one given time. So that put a major restriction on the shape of the back half of the truck itself. Wasn't able to have an elevated fifth wheel or an angled fifth wheel. I wasn't able to put a great amount of detail into that back section. You know, just limitations for actual use in this case. This thing is built in every direction imaginable, and even has some what I consider to be cheating going on with it. I'll show you that in just a minute. Doesn't really fit minifigs very well. It wasn't designed with minifigs in mind, basically at all. I did want to be able to show at least a minifig head in there, but that's not a complete minifig right now. That does not have legs on it, just has the body. I just really didn't care. I did not care whatsoever. It was not part of my mission parameters for the build of this thing to be completely minifig compatible. So I didn't have any accommodations for figures as I was building this, and that is perfectly fine because that's how I wanted to do it. I wanted to make this thing look good on the outside. I wanted to develop it into something that could be feasible, could be reasonable, could have kind of a brand image of some hypothetical company in my Lego world. And I feel like I've accomplished what I set out to do. I'm happy with the end result, and that's definitely what matters. What else to say about this? A lot of half stud movement, a lot of half plate movement in every direction. Got a little bit dirty with something on the back. Got those clear plates on there. That's to show. So that's kind of like when auto manufacturers put a clear cover over a supercar engine compartment or something to show you the engine from the outside. It's kind of like that, except this is not the manufacturer of this truck in universe showing off part of the interior of the cab. This is me showing off just a really funky little set of connections that were used to attach the back section of this that needed to negotiate around the half stud offset of stuff down below, the half stud offset of this rail and its holder here, the two stud offset of an assembly that holds this section here of the side of the windows upside down. You see that's upside down building right there above right side up building and below and to the sides of right side up building. So the brackets to hold all that together inside. So all that needed to be negotiated. I needed to get around that in order to attach the back of this. So what I did inside, I'll show you separately. It was this. Shameless cheating with the kind of T-bar version of kind of a lightsaber hilt sort of thing. And three of those small, what do you call those clear stud pieces, modified stud or tile pieces with the mini peg holder on the top, on top of a jumper, which creates an interesting shape and just fills an interesting space, exactly the way I needed it to. It leaves enough room to continue to build up vertically on the sides, to build in, and just creates, basically creates the fill that I needed. So that's what's going on. If you look at the actual truck, that's what's going on back here. So you see the edges of the brackets, got a couple more up top, and that's why I just left a little window too, just because it was kind of a weird thing. It's kind of cheating because the pieces are not pushed in all the way, sideways, laterally, they're not pushed in all the way. Had to be offset just ever so slightly. So I consider it to be cheating. I consider it to be kind of dirty. So I just left that open to let that be seen in the future. A little lacking in detail on the back, just in general. We got a little suggestion of engine there, but beyond that, like I said, the fifth wheel was not able to be elevated. It just cannot be done with the proportions and the spacing that I need for the trailers in my city. So that is what it is. You know, some compromises had to be made for the side view mirrors. I've gone with camera stocks, so this would not have external full mirrors. This would have just cameras, which would actually create greater visibility, smaller blind spots for the driver, and improve aerodynamics quite a bit. One thing about the fifth wheel is that it does have the ability to be moved back a stud, which is important with some longer and fuller trailers to allow, if you want to fully jackknife the thing 90 degrees to allow enough clearance for the corner to fit under there. And that kind of ends up going with the way that fifth wheels in real life are able to be slid forward and back to adjust to different weight placement and weight distribution on different types of trailers and such. But that's that. That's my truck. Need to kind of expand upon this theme now, because the nice thing this has done is kind of establish a time range, a near future time era, basically, for my city, which is what I want and what I have wanted for quite some time. Sorry about that right there. But, just kind of creates a little bit of an idea of what designs would look like that are absolutely modern. And now I can start making more things that look like they were made in the same year as this. You know, not more trucks, but other sorts of vehicles as well. And in the future, we'll still have old stuff on the road. You know, this is 2017 when this video is being recorded. Most vehicles on the road are not made in 2017. So I'll have the same sort of thing going on in my city, but this kind of opens up the door for some newer, more contemporary stuff, contemporary to the time period of the city. And I may make something else in the future that'll be from the same brand in universe, that'll use kind of that trademark shape for the front. Maybe I'll do a long nose semi or something. I'm not sure. We'll see. But that's all to come. That's it for this little build here. Hope you enjoyed looking at this. And, if you didn't, sorry about that, but I enjoyed making it, and I'm happy with the end result. So I will be talking to you again soon. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned.